Sinabi ni Jesus, mata sa mata, ngipin sa ngipin. Iyan ang sinasabi noon sa batas. Subalit ngayon, sinasabi ko sa inyo, kung sino man nagkasala sa iyo, huwag kayong gaganti. Sa halip, patawarin mo at kapahalin. Dear brothers and sisters, in the gospel today, the Lord tells his disciples, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. But I tell you now, I, Jesus, when somebody offends you, offer no resistance. You should even turn your cheek to him for another strike. Dear brothers and sisters, this is a very difficult commandment. It is a commandment, not a suggestion. The Lord did not tell us, well, if somebody offends you, I would like to suggest, if you wish, kindly forgive him. No, it is a command. It is a command that proves if a person is a disciple of Jesus or not. Isn't it that it's good? Somebody says, revenge is very sweet. Lintek lang mo ng ganti. Sa aking pagpupulay-pulay sa Ebanghelyo, nais ko pong magbigay ng isang katanungan sa ating lahat. Sino ba yung ating kaaway? Who is our enemy? The Lord has already explained to us who our neighbor is. We know our neighbor, but who is our enemy? Actually, it is very difficult to identify who our enemy is. In the first place, for example, I can say that I don't have an enemy. Honestly speaking, I don't have an enemy at the moment in my life. Wala akong kaaway. Subalit, kailangan mo bang pakinggan kung sinasabi ng Panginoon sa Ebanghelyo? And if I ask you, do you have enemies? Maybe one, but it's a long time ago. So, who is our enemy? Dear brothers and sisters, I would like to suggest to you one definition of an enemy. Who is our enemy? In a broader sense, sa malawak na pangunawa, our enemy is one who offends us. Ang ating kaaway ay yung nakakasakit sa atin. And that explains why in the Our Father, the Lord says, or the Lord taught us to pray, forgive us those who sin, who offend us, as we forgive, or forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who offend us. And these persons are our enemies in the broader sense. Who is our enemy? The Lord also tells us, commands us, that we have to forgive. But before that, we have to ask the question, You know, our enemy or enemies usually offend us with their words. Look at your hearts deep inside you. Examine the hurts, the wounds in your hearts. These words, these wounds were caused by words uttered by our enemies, words that offended us. Paano sinasaktan tayo ng ating kaaway? Sa pamamagitan ng salita. You know, our tongue is very powerful. Out of our tongue come bad words. And words are very interesting. They are fascinating. Why? Because they are invisible. We cannot see words. We cannot touch them. But if a word comes out of the malicious tongue, interestingly, this word, as if flies in the air and strikes the heart like an arrow. Bad words hurt us. Bad words kill the person inside. Hindi po ba yung mga nagkasakit sa inyo? Yun ang mga nagsalita ng masama sa inyo. And also, how do we offend others? We also offend them usually and almost always through our words. And that is why St. James in his letter tells us that we have to be very careful with our words. Because our tongue is so small, but it can light a fire. Yung bata pa po kami, may nagkasala po sa aking kapatid na maliit. That was 40 years ago. I remember I offended my young brother with my words. And you know, until now, I remember what I said to him. And it, you know, it pains me when I remember. Because I deeply wounded my brother. And whenever I remember what happened, I feel ashamed. Sinaktan ko ang aking kapatid, 4 na taon na ang nakakalipas. Hanggang ngayon, pag naalala ko, sumasakit ang aking puso. Because of my tongue, very little. But it can light a fire. You know, dear brothers and sisters, I know a leader of a country who always speaks terrible, bad words. I will not name the country. I will not name the leader of this country. But it's very bad. And you know, whenever he would belittle his enemies, political enemies, he would curse them. The Lord says, our words reflect the person we are. Out of the abundance of our heart, the mouth speaks. So, if this leader of this country, I will not name it for security reasons, if this leader speaks very bad words, then you have an insight into who he is. You know what's in his heart. The sad thing is, sometimes, people who hear him, his fans, when he speaks bad words, they clap their hands. That also reflects what's in their heart. So how do we forgive our enemies? If somebody hurts me with bad words, I will not hit back. I will not answer in kind. Hindi ko mag-iigali. When we forgive our enemies, when we don't hit back, that is how we love our enemies. The Lord did not tell us, okay, when you love your enemies, you have to cook adobo for him every day. No! The Lord tells us a simple thing. Don't hit back. Don't respond in kind. Don't curse him or her. Because if we curse our enemy, then we are the same. And the words, the poisonous words that come out of our mouths will also reflect the kind of person we are. Out of the abundance of our hearts, our mouths speak. Mga kapatid, sa ating pagpapatawad ng ating mga kaaway, kung minsan, hindi naaalis yung sakit, ay okay lang. Subalit hindi ito nangangahulugan na hindi na natin pinatawad ang ating kaaway. Marami ang nagsasabi sa akin, Father, hanggang ngayon hindi ko pa mapatawad ang aking kaaway. Bakit? Gumanti ka ba? Hindi naman, Father. Bakit? Nagsalita pa rin ng masama. Hindi rin, Father, pero masakit pa rin. Ay, pinatawad na yan. Kung minsan, nandiyan pa ang sakit ng puso kahit makalipas ang 4 na taon, ay okay lang po yan. Subalit, hindi na nangangahulugan na hindi mo na pinatawad. Dear brothers and sisters, sometimes when people hurt us, the pain remains in our hearts. The pain does not disappear. And the Lord did not promise that once we forgive those who offend us, the pain will go away. No. Sometimes the pain lasts for 10 years, 15 years, 20 years. I remember my grandmother, may she rest in peace, she's already in heaven. A few years before she died, she shared with me about her enemy before the war in the Philippines, 1942. And my grandmother was crying when she remembered her cousin telling her bad words. But then my grandmother said, I have already forgiven her, but the pain remains. So it's okay. It's okay to feel the pain. As long as we follow the command of Jesus, don't hit back. Don't say bad words against your enemies. In this way, we identify ourselves as Christians, as brothers and sisters. Finally, dear brothers and sisters, before I end my homily, sorry it's getting long, I'd like to suggest to you one good practice. First, I'd like to tell this in our language, Filipino. Alin mga kapatid, tayo mga Pinoy, mag-chismis. At kapag chinichismas natin yung kaaway natin, tumang-tuwa tayo, no? Ay, tama, totoo yan. Grabe yan. Sige pa, ang sarap-sarap talaga ng chismis na. Ay, okay lang kung pag-usapan natin yung iba. So, bakit? Kung pag-usapan natin yung iba, pag-usapan natin yung magaganda. lumapit na para sa paring sa akin at sinabi, alam mo, Raymond, tumutuwa ako sa iyo kasi yung magandang sinabi mo sa akin, nakarating sa akin. It's good that, you know, maganda naman at maganda yung sinabi ko. You see, one way of being charitable is to speak good words about the others. Dear brothers and sisters, before I end my homily, I'd like to suggest a very practical point. You know, sometimes human nature, you know, urges us to speak ill of others, to talk about their lives, you know, about their sins, about their days. And that is, sometimes it happens anywhere, in every part of the world. But you know, it's okay to talk about others as long as we talk about good things, referring to their persons. In this way, we will be free to talk about others. And that is also the example of Jesus in the Gospel. Jesus never uttered a bad word, even if he was attacked many times by the Pharisees, by his enemies. Never did bad word come out of Jesus' mouth. We too should be like Jesus. Because when we are like Jesus, people will see that. Whenever we speak good words, we say, people will say, aha, he always speaks good, inspiring words. And that's also what is in his heart. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you and leave you.